Do you think the administration is going overboard with deportations and that this case illustrates that?
No, it doesn't, because this kind of thing actually happens kind of frequently. It's a huge organization, Homeland Security, and wires get crossed. One of my analysts, in fact, used to be a prosecutor for the INS, used to be an immigration judge. He said it happened to him with one of his cases. You know, these things happen, and they found out about it later. The people never even got off the plane. The whole thing about holding the attorney general in contempt and what have you, that's showboating by the judge, because this is the kind of screw-up that frankly happens, and it was resolved. It's not even really a story.
How is it appropriate for the First Lady to use chain migration and other people not able to use that?
Well, everybody's able to use it because the rules are still there. There's no
Well, but the president
implication.
Wants to end that, Mark. You know
yeah,
that.
But,
the president wants
you know,
to end that, so why is it okay for the First Lady to do it and all of these other people not able to do it?
But my point is everybody now is able to do it. If the rules change, then the First Lady wouldn't be able to do it either. Look, it's kind of like, say, the mortgage interest deduction. There are real arguments that that's a bad idea. You know, when you fill out your taxes, you deduct your mortgage interest, home mortgage interest from your income. There's arguments, sound arguments. I don't know where I fall on that, but there are sound arguments we should get rid of it. Does that mean that if you believe in those arguments, you should not take the mortgage interest deduction? It'd be ridiculous.
Well,
nobody
let me
does
ask
that.
You this.
You'd be an idiot.
Since
so
you're against
the point
this
is,
issue,
policy,
you're against this use of chain migration, Mark, if I could ask you this, do you think that the First Lady's parents should have been blocked from coming into the country?
If we had changed the rules before then, yes. Or actually, wait, let me qualify that, because the bill that the president was promoting that actually almost passed in the House would not have prevented the First Lady's parents from coming. It just would have not given them green cards. They would have been able to stay with a renewable visitor visa so that they didn't end up going on Medicare. That, so I mean, in a sense, this specific example doesn't even highlight what the critics are trying to say, that it's hypocritical or ironic.